Dear students, today we are going to discuss about scales, which is unit 2 in our subject Engineering Drawing 1, BCE 101. So this is the very first lecture, okay? And in this lecture on scales, we will see first of all what is the importance of scales, what are scales, what is the importance of scaling, or what is the importance of scales as far as engineering drawings are concerned. Why do we need to draw scales? Why do we need to have an idea of different types of scales when we are going to have some engineering drawing? Okay, so these things will be discussed in today's lecture. Okay, so first of all, let's see what is the importance of scales. Why do we need scales in our drawings? See, what happens actually, what we want to show by means of our drawings, what objects we need to show by means of our drawings. So those objects are of two types. Either the objects which have to be drawn on the drawing sheet, either they are too large as compared to the drawing sheet, or they are too small as compared to the drawing sheet. So what we have to do, we have to either enlarge the size of the object so that it can fit on the drawing sheet, or we have to reduce the size of the object on the drawing sheet so that the entire object can be accommodated within the area of the drawing sheet. Okay. So the proportion by which the drawing of an object is enlarged or reduced, that is known as scale of the drawing. Okay. So a scale is defined as the ratio of the linear dimensions of the object as represented in a drawing to the actual dimensions of the same. That means, how do we define a scale? Scale is the ratio of linear dimension of the object as represented in the drawing upon actual dimension of the object which is available at the site. For example, we have to draw a bridge which is almost 50 kilometers in length, and that bridge has to be drawn, that the drawing of the bridge has to be drawn on the drawing sheet. So we'll first of all reduce the size. So that reduced size, as is represented in the drawing sheet, so that size upon the actual size, this is a scale. Okay. Now scales, based on the methods of preparing, they will be of three types. Either we will use the full size, okay. Either we will use full size scales. Full size scale means the size has neither been reduced nor been enlarged. The size is as it is. That is full size. Reduced size means the actual size of the object is large as compared, as in case of buildings, heavy machines, bridges. So these are large objects. So their size need to be reduced so that it can be accommodated in the drawing sheet. Then enlarged size, for example, we have to draw a watch, hand watch. So hand watch is such a small thing, small object. So its size has to be enlarged, has to be increased so that it can accommodate the size of the drawing sheet. Okay. Now, there are several BIS recommended scales. What is BIS basically? Bureau of Indian Standards. It is a government body that deals with the standardization of things. Okay. So BIS codes are there for different types of designings. Similarly, BIS has recommended some scales. So there are basically three types of scales. Reducing scales. In case of reducing scales, you can see the denominator part is large as compared to numerator part. Because what we do, we basically decrease the size in reducing scale. We are decreasing the size when we are representing it on the drawing sheet. Okay. Then is the enlarging scales. Enlarging scales means we are increasing the size of the object as compared to the original size. And then full size scales, that means neither the size is being enlarged nor reduced. Now there are two types of scales, engineer's scale and graphical scale. Engineer's scale, basically in engineer's scale, we numerically represent the relationship between the dimensions in the drawing and the actual dimension. For example, we draw some drawing and just write at the bottom 10 mm is equal to 15 meter. That means a 10 mm line represents actually 15 meter of the actual dimension. Okay, so there is no actual ratio, there is no scaling here, no ratio actually. Okay, and in the other case, graphical scale, what happens? A scale is drawn on the drawing itself. A scale is drawn on the drawing, and that scale represents what is the ratio of the original size and the size on the drawing sheet. Okay, now let's see what are the different types of graphical scales. As far as graphical scales are concerned, in this unit we will talk about three main types of graphical scales. These are plane scale, diagonal scale and vernier scale. Plane scale, diagonal scale and vernier scale. Okay, before discussing these three types of scales in detail, let's see a term known as representative fraction, RF. Representative fraction. What is this RF? What is this representative fraction? See, when a 1 centimeter long line in a drawing represents 1 meter length of the object, then this ratio, this is known as representative fraction. Okay. A 1 centimeter long line in a drawing, that is representing how much? 1 meter length of the actual size, actual object. So RF will be equal to 1 centimeter upon 1 meter. So why do we calculate this? By means of calculating RF, or if we know the RF value, representative fraction value, what we will do? We can easily calculate the length of the scale. Okay. What length of the scale should we draw on the drawing sheet? Okay, what optimum length or what should be the maximum length of the scale which we have to draw on the drawing sheet? So that is calculated by means of RF. So length of the scale will be equal to RF into maximum distance to be represented. RF into maximum distance to be represented. Okay, so this will be equal to, say, for the maximum length to be represented is 15 meter. Then RF is 1 centimeter upon 1 meter into 15 meter. So this is equal to 15 centimeter. That means a 15 centimeter long scale has to be drawn on the drawing sheet. Okay. Now let's discuss the first type of scale, plane scale. As you can see, there is a drawing also drawn. This is a plane scale. Okay, so how do we draw this? First of all, what is the use of a plane scale? When will we draw a plane scale? When will we draw a diagonal scale? When we will use a vernier scale? These things should also be clear. Okay. Now, a plane scale is used to indicate the distance in a unit and its next subdivision. Unit and its next subdivision. That means if we have to show a distance of, say, for 3.5 decimeter. Okay, 3.5 decimeter. So what we will use, since we need a scale which should indicate values up to first decimal place, so we will use a plane scale. If we have to show a distance of 3.56, so now we need a scale which should represent the values up to two decimal place, so then we will use a diagonal scale. If suppose we have to represent a value equal to 3.567, so we need a scale which should represent three decimal places, then that scale is vernier scale. Okay, so based on the representation, based on how much decimal place we have to represent, we will choose the scale. Okay, now a plane scale consists of a line divided into suitable number of equal units. The first unit is subdivided into smaller parts. Okay, as you can see in this figure, what is happening? The entire length, this entire length has been divided into 5 equal parts. And we have started 0. 0 is showing not at the starting point, but 0 is showing at the end of first part. The 0 should be placed at the end of the first main unit. First main unit, at the end of the first main unit, 0 should be placed. Okay, then 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are the decimeters. Okay, and each alternate bands should be white and black. If one is white, then the other one should be this black. Then white, then black, just for representation. Now what we will do, from the zero mark, the units should be numbered to the right. Zero mark, units should be numbered to the right and the subdivisions to the left. Okay, subdivisions will be marked left. Since 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeter, 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeter, so we will divide this 1 decimeter into 10 equal parts. So these are the centimeters, 0 to 10 centimeters. Okay. Now RF should be mentioned below the scale. The representative fraction should be mentioned below the scale. So this is how we are going to draw a plane scale. Now let's see an example. Construct a plane scale of RF equal to 1.4 to show centimeters and long enough to measure up to 5 decimeter and show distance of 3.7 decimeter. Okay, so RF is given and we have to show what? Centimeters. And it should be long enough to measure up to 5 decimeter. Maximum length to be drawn, 5 decimeter. And what we have to represent on this scale? 3.7 decimeter. So first of all, RF is given, 1 by 4. What we will calculate? We will calculate the length of the scale. So length of the scale will be equal to representative fraction into maximum length. Representative fraction into maximum length. So this is equal to 1 by 4 into 5 decimeter. Okay, so this is coming out to be 12.5 centimeter. That means we have to draw a line 12.5 centimeter long and divide it into 5 equal parts, each representing 1 decimeter. Okay, total length of the scale we calculated 12.5. Now just divide it into 5 equal parts, because we have to show 5 decimeters. So each part will be equal to 1 decimeter. Then mark 0 at the end of the first division. Just see here. Mark 0 at the end of the first division. After first division, we marked 0. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then divide the first division into 10 equal subdivisions. Divide the first division into 10 equal subdivisions so that each can represent 1 centimeter. Okay. This is representing each line is representing 1 centimeter, and here each division is 1 decimeter. Okay, so we wrote decimeter here and centimeter here. Now draw the scale as a rectangle of small width. What we will do, we will create a small width, that means just give it a height of say for around 3 mm. Okay, so that this should look like a rectangle. Okay, so we took a height of 3 mm. Okay, and then we draw it just as a rectangle, just as a scale. You must have seen, actually the scale is what? Scale is rectangular in shape. So just to give that picture, we are representing this also as a rectangle. Then draw thick and dark horizontal lines in the middle of all alternate divisions and subdivisions. Okay, dark and thick lines at the end of each alternate divisions. See, this is blank, here we have dark lines, then this is blank, dark lines, here also dark line, then one gap, then dark line, then one space, then dark line, then one space. So just in alternate numbers. Now below the scale, print decimeters on the right hand side, centimeter on the left hand side, and RF in the middle. RF in the middle, decimeter on the right, centimeter on the left. Now what we have to show on this scale? 3.7 decimeter. So first of all, we'll pick up 3 decimeter, 0 1 2 3. So this is 3 decimeter. Okay, what do we need else? 0.7 decimeter, yani 0.7 decimeter means 7 centimeter. So what we will do? 1 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So this point is 7 centimeter. Okay, so this distance from here to here, this is 3.7 decimeter, and these lines which have been drawn at 45 degree. Okay, you may draw this also, or you can skip also. It is not much needed in this plane scale. Okay, so this is all about the plane scales. Okay, in our next lecture we will see how to draw diagonal scales and then vernier scales.